peanut cookies. Happy for that?
Peanut cookies.
Yeah, peanut cookies.
Oh, now, peanuts. That's too bad. My favorite nut is the cashew.
Is it?
Wait, the cashew.
Hmm?
Cashew.
Cashew.
What?
Cashew.
Gesundheit. Yeah. I got you, Kermit.
You did, Gam. I fell right into that one.
He's one of his closest friends. He's actually at the door right now.
There he is. Oh my gosh. Was that?
Oh, Bobby. Oh.
Morning, Robbie.
Hello. That was
Oh, lovely. Lovely to see you. So, Blobby, do you think he can win in there?
Yes,
absolutely. Yep. Oh, there he goes.
Are you okay there? Well, there goes half the set.
You must have got used to all of this, surely.
Well, again, I mean, they're like with Mr. Blobby, totally unexpected. I mean, it's like if anyone had asked me when I was working with Noel on Swap Shop, would he be working with Mr. Blobby? I would have gone.
Maybe this is the best preparation he could have had for Jungle Life.
Yes.
This is maybe. Maybe
this is a moment I never expected to have.
We can only apologise. Thank you so much. Thank you both. Yes. Lovely to see you, Bobby. Thank you. Maggie, thank you so much. And thanks to John as well in Bristol. Still to come, former Queen of the Jungle, Vicky Patterson, has the latest on I'm a Celebrity and former King of the Jungle. Did you just punch him? She just punched him.
Oh, no.
I think he's winded.
Now, I've got a few here, but I need you to give them a bit of a whack with that pin.
Oh, really?
Can you do that?
Oh, okay.
No, don't go mad. Don't hit him. Oh, perfect.
That good?
Yes, just perfect. One? Keep going.
Keep going.
This reminds me of a joke. Go on.
Two peanuts were walking down the street.
Go on then.
One was assaulted.
He's not happy. Right.
Now, listen, Sesame Street turns 50, as we said before, later this year. What are you going to do to celebrate? Is there a big party and are we invited?
Oh, you want to come?
Yes.
Of course you're invited.
Yeah, I would love to come.
Invited. Yeah, it's a big deal. 50 years of Sesame Street.
Yeah,
Very exciting.
I'm going to make a cake that's 50 stories high.
I'm going to eat that cake.
Nice.
I totally want to eat that. Cookie Monster, I have something to say to you, to have a very special thank you, because when I was a little boy and I went to the United States when I was a long time ago, I learned my ABCs by visiting Sesame Street every single day.
Wow.
And I learned how to read, too. So
really?
Tell everybody at Sesame Street, thank you very much.
We will do that.
Please.
We love to hear that.
Are you guys ready to make cookies?
Cookie.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
This is brilliant. This is how my kitchen looks over Easter holidays.
They come out like this one here. John, Michelle, that's yours.
Thank you.
Cookie Monster.
Cookie
Monster, that's yours. Look at that.
Cookie Monster, ready? Are you going to show me how to eat cookies?
Yeah.
Like this.
Go.
Say, cookie! That's impressive.
These feel like the kind of perfect thing.
Does it excite you to do a big live show like this?
Oh, are you kidding me? Yes, absolutely. I am so looking forward to the waves of applause and love and admiration to wash over moi.
You know, Miss Piggy, live means that anything can happen, and if things go wrong, we just have to keep going.
Is that what excites you about a live show?
Yeah. You know, it kind of describes every show we do, but this time the audience gets to see it right before their eyes, and that's what makes it so exciting.
Do you get nervous? I mean, 60,000 people is a lot of people.
I don't get nervous.
No, I
give other people nervous breakdowns.
Yes.
But I don't get nervous.
No, of course. That is true.
Well, this was massive in America, and it's obviously going to be huge here. And are there plans now for global domination? You taking it around the world?
Oh.
Well, I you know what? We don't really have any definite plans. We actually don't even know what we're going to do this afternoon.
Oh.
But we'd love to tour around the world, around the block, you know?
Yeah.
Sure.
Heck, the truth is we'll play anywhere folks are interested in seeing talking frogs, singing pigs, and joke-telling bears.
Yeah, which everybody loves moi, so it makes sense.
And you are looking particularly beautiful, Piggy, I have to say.
Thank you.
We'd like some advice, actually, because I think, is it right? We've been together 12 years. Mm. You've got 30 years on us. So what's your kind of advice for keeping this relationship, this working relationship going?
Well, you know, let me start, Piggy, if you don't mind.
Oh, please do.
Okay. You know, we've always gotten along great. And when we have a disagreement, we always work it out. Isn't that right?
Yeah, or you just say yes.
Or I just say yes, yes. Yeah.
You see?
Yes.
Just a yes.
I always do. That's the only way it works. And what about, because I'm sure a lot of people who are watching would wonder whether love would blossom once more for you.
Oh, it would be nice. We're kind of waiting for it. It's been a while.
No.
You know, I think we are both happy being together at work, right? But we keep our romantic lives very separate.
Very separate.
That's right. And you know, it's working for me.
How about you?
No, we're sort of married to other people. But
sort of?
Well, no, we are.
We are.
We are.
Yeah, definitely.
Does this mean
no.
tonight?
No. But so the thing is that you guys in the past have, you know, you have been there. It has happened between you and, you know.
Yeah, but, you know, as for, I think what you're saying is you're trying to skirt around getting back together.
Yeah, well, we'd all like to see that, I think. I mean, I kind
would
of...
Would you? Yeah. Would you now?
Yeah.
Of course, it was a lovely relationship.
I'd like to see you two get together.
Piggy.
You do that, and maybe the frog can be
for now, let's just say no.
Okay, fair enough.
How does that feel, huh? How does that feel when other people want you to get together?
We have struck a nerve. I'm so sorry. I just, you know, it's what we... It's because we love both of you, that's why.
Oh, that's so sweet.
That is what it is. I think I
But you do love me
well.
More, right?
I do love you more, of course. Yes. I always have.
You know, I am sitting right here.
They were the group who stormed to the top of the charts in December 1997 when they were number one for 2 weeks with their debut single.
Well, it's so lovely to see you. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Tinky Winky, Dipsy, La La and Poe.
You're here to perform, so please, would you go and do your number? Good luck.
Was banned.
Feast your eyes on this, because this could well be the last time you see him in the flesh, because tickling is out. There you are.
Oh, look, and he's so jolly. What? Hello, Mr. Tickle.
Is that won't like it. Stay away from her.
No. You have to ask
Thank you, Mr. Tickle. Mr. Tickle. Not the day for that, believe me.
That might be the last time you see Mr. Tickle allowed to do it without asking permission.
Now, you see...
Did you know that Mr. Tickle was the first in the Mr. Tickle
I just
Tickle
said
books?
That, darling.
Yeah, but do you know why?
Why?
Because his son, so Roger Hargreaves, the author, his son said to him when he was little, Daddy, I wonder what a tickle would look like.
Well,
and that's where the idea came
from. Looking at that tickle is Lottie Daly. She's a friend of Russell Brand's, and she's against tickling. And beside her, Vanessa Feltz, who's all in favour of it. Lottie, how does it make you feel looking at Mr. Tickle over your shoulder there?
I feel really intimidated. What's he going to do to me?
Yeah.
Seriously.
And your point, but he's not going to do anything, Mr. Tickle.
He's going now.
Yeah, go on, sling your hair.
I said no.
Don't build your path.
Right.